What is up, what is up? Bisectatron here, back with today's video, and today we are talking about some of the best Town Hall 13 attacks Hog Riders, Miners, and both Hog Riders and Miners, aka the hybrid attack. All of these using a bunch of heal spells. This is a new meta at Town Hall 13. We're seeing a lot working, we're seeing Yeti Smash, we're seeing other stuff as well. But a trend I've noticed is a lot of these attacks, these heal spell-based attacks, Hog Riders, Miners, and then, of course, the hybrid as we're seeing in this attack, it's all working. And I have a kind of a theory why. We're going to be taking a look at three attacks today. This first one is by myself using the hybrid strategy. And I think that, you know, obviously we've had the heal spell, level 8 heal spell, which has been helpful for this. We've had level 7 Miners. Level 10 Hog Riders, pretty much everything, all the big stuff has gotten a new level at Town Hall 13 that you use in these strategies. That's one thing. Also, the rise of the Siege Barracks. Check out my previous video on how to use the Siege Barracks on Miner attacks. That's been very strong. Definitely made Miners a little bit stronger in the process. And I think also the new hero, the Royal Champion, pairs well with Hog Riders and even with Miners too, because she can kind of cut across the base and take out defenses and take out, you know, heroes, skeletons, stuff that can be a pain for Hog Riders, especially, and even Miners to some extent. So she kind of, you know, complements these strategies well. The combination of all of that, I think, has really made this a strong strategy, whether, you know, it's Hog Riders or Miners. And even some of the Sui Hog, which I think we're going to take a look at in this video as well. So all of these heal spell based attacks are working well. In this one, the base was perfect for it because the Town Hall was kind of separated from the core on the outside. I went ahead and used the Slammer to kind of let my king into the base to create the other side funnel. There wasn't really an easy way to do it besides that. And then, of course, just straight pathing through the Eagle and through a lot of those high DPS units such as the Defensive Queen and Expos. They pushed through nicely. Warden's ability, Champ's ability, got the job done in the core, and then the Queen is still alive on the outside. So worked out very well. Fast forward here for sake of time, and we'll move on to some other attacks. But this is all good stuff to know if you're a Town Hall 13, you know, at this point in the game. So let's move on here. We have two, three, and four. That's easy enough. This was a more of a Sui Hog type attack. And you guys are going to see how powerful this was. We have a little baby mortar there, which is kind of weird to see that. Actually, all these mortars are... Okay, I think that's kind of a statement to Supercell, maybe, about the quality of the mortars. But, you know, I'd personally choose to upgrade them, but, you know, that's on the defender here. Maybe this attack wouldn't have worked if it was max mortars. Who knows? Kind of weird there. Didn't notice that before. But anyway, this was kind of a nice attack. Used the Siege Barracks in a new way. This is different than kind of the what I've previously covered, which has been the use on the Queen Charge Miners. Just use it in the kill squad. The extra P.E.K.K.A., extra wizards helped kind of push in, get the Queen and the Town Hall, which is kind of the essentials. Then other side, we have the Warden, the Hogs, and the Champ all pair very nicely together. And just coming at the base, it's a bit wide, you know, definitely wider than the width of a heal spell. So it's more of a mass hog attack rather than more of a precision queen charge type hog attack where you want everything about within the width of a heal spell. So things kind of spread out weird as they will in this type of attack. But the champ is going to be very important here. She does a lot of work on the top side of this base. This is stuff that otherwise would have been a big nuisance for the hogs. She takes out, Inferno Tower, Wizard Tower, bunch of other defenses there too, really kind of leaves a pretty bare top part of the base. And that's the difference, you know, what Town Hall 12 didn't have, Town Hall 13 does with that extra push the champ provides. The level 50 Warden also does quite a bit of damage, and he's going to target those defenses as well because that's what the hogs are having, so he'll have some as well. Very, 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 very strong strategy. Just the pure power, especially when you get that Siege Barracks used in your kill squad, adding an extra P.E.K.K.A., an extra like 8 wizards or whatever it is, that's a lot of power going into the base. So big fan of this strategy, look to use it as well. take a look at one more here. We saw the hybrid. We saw hogs. So I think you can guess what's next. We got to take a look at miners to kind of complete this little family of attack strategies here. And this was a nice queen charge miner attack. Doesn't use the siege barracks. Uses the slammer, and we'll see how in just a moment. Nice funnel, some loons, baby dragon. Do what you got to do on the funnel. Important stuff there. I like how that balloon gets the, yep, there it gets the archer tower taken out, which is nice for funneling purposes. The queen's not going to be distracted by all these buildings up here. She'll go straight in. Nice little balloon to check for some seeking air mines. And queen hops on in there, has a rage for her as well, and also the freezes. One thing to keep in mind, sometimes two freezes is better than one rage when it comes to keeping up your queen. Not always, but just kind of think about as my queen goes through, especially if the base has been hit before, what's the queen going to encounter, and can maybe one freeze do the job of what one rage would have otherwise done? That leaves you with a second freeze almost for free if you think about it like that. So, you know, be aware of that. Anyway, queen pushes through here, has to deal with the triple ice golem CC. I'm kind of on the fence about that. I like the hound witch CC a little better, but we'll see how they shape up going into the future. King on the other side, wizards, miners pushing through. Has that Tesla farm, which is perfect for miner pathing here. Get it out, taken out early, and it'll lead them right into the town hall. So that's all good stuff there. Goes ahead and gets a nice freeze there on the warden queen. That's a bunch of DPS that otherwise would have been coming at her. Neutralized very nicely there. Saves the queen's ability a little bit longer. Goes ahead and pops it right there, though. Meanwhile, the warden's ability over the town hall. Miners pushing through. The royal champ sitting back. Only level 9, mind you. I mean, we're not even seeing level 20 royal champs for the most part. But she continues through. Still has her ability. And I like the siege slammer there coming in. Not much air coverage in the area. Kind of a vulnerability of the base. It's going to get good value. And some hogs will pop out as well. I guess, you know, could have dropped the top of the base, the siege barracks with the P.E.K.K.A. and the wizards. And, you know, you could make an argument for using that. But in this case, I think there is good value in taking out, like, you know, 3 or 4 defenses with the slammer itself before the hogs even come out. As long as you have the time to do it, because the siege barracks will help you with cleanup. But you don't always need that extra cleanup to start that early. So anyway, that'll do it for this attack and for this video. Thanks for watching. Main point of the video, look to use this stuff at Town Hall 13. It's very strong and can work on a lot of different bases. So that'll do it, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bisectatron out.